welcome to March. February is finally over, which is awesome. I always say it has the shortest amount of days because it sucks the most. Did you know more people kill themselves in the month of February than any other month, which is why, thank goodness, it's the shortest month, but then also why I felt it was super important in March to have this reading center around our happiness, okay? So there are a lot of reasons why people watch these videos, but at the very core of it, I think that people are watching because they want some good news, right? They want something to look forward to. In the words of Omar Suleiman, a very wise guy, he says that the keys to happiness are three things: something to love, something to do, and something to look forward to. So hopefully I'm going to give you all of those in this reading. So even if your life is already full of joy and happiness and bliss, if you're just wanting to hear some validation about these good vibes that you're already feeling, that, you know, to hear you're already on the right path, that you're making the right choices, the right decisions, for that sense of security, security does bring happiness, right? Knowing what to expect. At the end of the day, happiness is what we're all seeking. It's the reason why we seek out help, why we would use tarot reader, why we would look up our horoscope. This is why we're doing this, okay? We are fiends for happiness. It's the ultimate drug. And so this is what we're focusing on in March. So this will be for your sun, moon, or rising sign. A lot of times, because our moon sign correlates to our emotions and how we feel, which is a lot of times why we make the decisions we make, that might resonate a little bit better for you. So it might be advisable to watch your moon sign as well as your sun sign. And then you could do your rising sign as well too, if you'd like to. What did I want to say? Okay, so since we're focusing on happiness for March and how to kind of sustain that throughout the year, this is how we're going to look at it. We're going to do where are you at right now? What is tainting any feelings of happiness that you otherwise should have right now? What will make you feel happy, or at least what you think will? How is that perception true? How is that perception false? What will actually make you the most happy this month? And then we're going to look at the forces that are kind of outside of your control, right, that is affecting this state, and which ones that are not really within your power are kind of accelerating your happiness, and then which ones are decelerating that. We're going to look at what's going to bring you luck this month, your crystal of the month, your color energy, your lucky days, and then also any energies that you need to kind of bring into your life in order to help the happiness thrive, how to sustain the happiness once you get some, and then just kind of like a recap or overall nutshell of what March will look like for your sign. So, kind of thinking about, you know, okay, well, is this reading going to be enough because it's for each specific zodiac sign? Each sign has their own. Then I was thinking, those of you who have followed me for a long time might remember stop, drop, roll readings, where it's something that you stop doing, something you drop from your life, and something you should roll with. I think I'm going to do a special on those, but really kind of amped up or accelerated in order to really harness in on that happiness sort of life coaching aspect. And the reason why I think this is important in March is because, number one, it's the perfect time for spring cleaning, right? Number two, the popularity of Marie Kondo right now, and, you know, sort of thinking about, let's get rid of the things that don't bring me joy. Let's just focus on the things that bring me joy. And, you know, we all are always looking for joy. We're either trying to increase pleasure or decrease pain. And so that's kind of the purpose of this reading. And then here's the other thing. We're about to step into this Mercury retrograde. We're in the pre-shadow period right now as I record this. And so then when it hits us, in order to use this time in its fullest potential, we want to very much evaluate, okay, this isn't working for me. I want to pitch this and I want to do something that's going to make my life better. It's going to make me happier. It's going to make me more joyful, more satisfied with life. And so I think I'm going to offer that like in sort of a goals and coaching, very intensive sort of way as a special. Once I decide to do that, if you're on the email list, I only send one email a month, so don't let that be a reason why you're not on my list. Then you'll be notified of that. And if there's like a coupon code or something, that would be in there. If you're not on the list, you should be, because I give away, like I said, it's only one email a month, but every single month I give away a free 20-minute video reading to a random person selected from my list. So that being said, I'm sorry if this long intro did not bring you joy, if it decreased your happiness, but now you know what to expect in your reading. So let's get started. Hi, Virgo. So welcome to March. Okay, so in March, where are you right now? And they're saying you might not be feeling tremendous amount of spunk or that like go get 'em attitude, which could be sort of normal in a Mercury retrograde energy. However, they're also saying like you're not sort of consciously making decisions, which is a good thing because, you know, you're not judging others, you're not judging yourself. But in that process of like not feeling an enthusiasm, not making discernments and judgments, you're also not walking away from something that you need to. And that's sort of the issue here with Mercury retrogrades. Like, it calls situations from our past to our attention now so that we can move past them, so that we can say, oh, okay, you know what? There's a little bit of unresolved stuff here, and now I want to move past that. Oftentimes, though, in a Mercury retrograde, we step back into that energy, and we don't necessarily do it with the intention of resolving things and moving on. So that's just something to be aware of. They're saying, you know, a lot of you are kind of going back to old situations that didn't work for you, old ways of thinking, behavioral patterns, relationships. And so be conscious of that. You might want to make a different choice. So in talking about your happiness, what could be tainting any feelings of happiness right now in the month of March? And they're saying, you know, honestly, there's not this like heavy disappointment energy. You are doing some healing, but you don't necessarily notice it. It's not super apparent to you. You might not be feeling tremendously successful. You might be a little bit down on yourself. Your confidence isn't super high. And they're saying, we want you to really embody this Empress card. And, you know, I have a client who, I'm sure you're watching, so hi. Anyway, she very much has had this come up in her readings as you need to be the Empress, you need to be the Empress, you need to be the Empress over the last couple of months. And so this is a message for all Virgos, not just her, that you want to be this, you know, confident and nurturing, loving personality. And you really very much are a loving and nurturing person. You know, people make fun of Virgos all the time and say that they're like hypercritical, you know, but you do it out of love. Like, you want everybody to be, you're a little bit of a perfectionist. You want everybody to be the best possible version of themselves. However, when it comes to your own self, you can be very self-critical. So we don't want to talk to ourselves the way that we, you know, we want to talk to ourselves the way that we would talk to other people. You wouldn't look at somebody who made a mistake and say, yeah, you're a piece of shit. Like, everything is total garbage. You're always such a failure. Also, you look fat. Like, we wouldn't say that, but we would say that to ourselves, right? And instead, we want to embrace this Empress energy where it's like, if the sun stopped shining, I would shine in its place. Like, I am a very loving, compassionate, you know, spiritual being, because you are. Hello, everybody else can see it. So why are you so critical of yourself? It's silly. And so not embracing that is maybe what's not making you feel that maximum capacity of happiness this month, and then also not letting go of shit that's bad for you that we know you need to. And when that devil card comes up, you know, sometimes it's not necessarily people. It could be addictions. Maybe you have a drinking problem, or maybe you're a smoker. And it's like, okay, now's the time to move on from that, you know? But instead, you're just hitting it a little harder, and that's how you're dealing with your stress. And it's like, because you'd be much happier if you did it, even though it would be a challenge. But you know, the things worth doing are often a challenge. And it's funny, the timing of this video, because this morning, gosh, I'm going to look this up. I sent a text message to my bestie that said, I heard today someone say obstacles are hurdles in the right direction. And I thought that you might like to hear that. If you really think about it, it totally makes sense. Anything you really want to do that didn't contain struggle or hardship, would you actually appreciate the end result? We value things most when they're reminiscent to underdog stories. Like every movie is an underdog story, right? If everything is easy, we do not appreciate the outcomes. I love you. And she said, I did need that. Thank you, baby, because she's like the sweetest, most loving human in the world. But my point here is, like, sometimes we think, oh, okay, I'm doing something wrong. I need to change paths because I've encountered an obstacle. And, like, it would just naturally flow to me if it was right for me. But no, that's like some shitty-ass self-talk. Because oftentimes we need those hurdles and those challenges even along our correct path in order to teach us something that makes us stronger and to make us feel like what we're doing is valuable, right? And that's what helps us embrace that real empress energy, right? So anyway, that's kind of where you guys are at. And so even if something is strong, is like difficult, remember that it's either a good thing or it's good for you. So what do you think will make you happy in the month of March? And they're saying stability and comfort, as well as, you know, kind of exploring all of the things that bring you joy. So there's this definite confusion energy that you have going on here. You're not sure what's most important to you. And honestly, figuring that out is a very difficult task, but once you do, it's kind of revolutionary. I noticed in my own self that when I discovered that I value time more than money, that, oh, it totally makes sense why I self-sabotage. It totally makes sense why I don't take opportunities to make a lot of money, because I realize it's going to eat up a lot of my free time. It's going to eat up my time with my children and things like that. And so therefore, it's not worth it. The most money in the world is not worth it to me if it means I'm not going to be able to spend time with my kids or my sister or, you know, my best friends. So kind of how do we narrow that down? And they're saying, looking at the areas that are out of balance in your life, whether that's work-life balance, whether that's your finances, whether, you know, your house is a mess, whatever, looking specifically at that and saying, okay, so is it so out of balance because it's not a priority, or is it a priority and I'm just not making the decision to break a pattern or a habit to create a change to move on from this, you know, specific lifestyle or circumstance? And, you know, what is the issue there? So they're saying by the new moon, you want to have figured this out and kind of look at each challenge and say, is this worth it or not? And especially from an emotional standpoint, you know, is this relationship that is difficult worth having if it's always causing me strain or stress in my life? And then kind of cutting out things bit by bit once you make those discoveries. And they say you don't necessarily have the confidence to do that, which is why we're trying to give you that Empress energy. So, you know, when we're talking about what's going to make you happy and you're like, oh, so many things, so many things, how is that perception true? And they're saying, well, honestly, a lot of it isn't true. A lot of you guys are looking at the things that make you sad or disappointed, but you're afraid to change them. And so it's not true. It's that fear of change. It's that fear of the unknown that's kind of holding you back. So we kind of know already how your perception is false, but they're saying the key here is balance and then understanding why you're not choosing to move on from things that cause disruption and emotional turmoil in your life. Why is that? It's a fear of the unknown for most of you. And so you've really got to kind of move past that and just trust in the universe and God and even in yourself. They're saying the imbalance is going to be real strong for a lot of Virgos this month. And, you know, it might even continue into April for a lot of you. And some of you are going to find that getting more sleep or better quality sleep will be very, very helpful. So that's the first piece of guidance for most of you. And then the rest of you, it's about just taking things slower, that you can forgive yourself if you're not super quick. You know, if you do demand that you complete things, you know, in the very perfect, very typical Virgo kind of way, you know, what's the point in doing it if you're not going to do it right? It's okay to take your time then. Okay. So what will actually make you happy this month? And they say, some of you actually are going to find a lot of happiness in continuing on in these same destructive patterns, whether they're addictions, whether they're toxic relationships or whatever. A lot of you are kind of really enjoying just wallowing in it. Some of you are getting a good amount of satisfaction in that just because you're like, okay, even though it's fucked up and it's wrong and I hate it, it's comfortable because I know what to expect, right? Now, for the rest of you who have the bravery and the courage to step away from those things, you guys will be a much more emotionally balanced. Now, they're saying it might take you a while. And again, you have to be patient with yourself. And but, you know, you won't feel as crazy as you typically might in this type of a process, especially during a Mercury retrograde. This is going to work in your favor. And they're saying, so you will have a lot of feelings, but you'll be in greater control of those feelings. And it's not selfish to do what's right for you. You need to remember that. You are not selfish if you're doing what's right for you. You need to put yourself first and foremost, because you're the only person who's going to do that. Okay? So what kind of forces are at play outside of your control in favor of your happiness? And they're saying people are going to be bringing you messages. And I'm not getting this as like, you know, spiritual messages. I'm not saying like, oh, your spirit guides are going to whisper something in your ear. I mean, that's possible, but I feel like this is actual humans. I mean, there's going to be a good amount of potential criticism here, where somebody might have something to say to you and you don't necessarily take this immediately the right way. You kind of might go, whoa, what are you saying? But if you're really, really patient with yourself and with the other person, it'll give you really great insight and create that emotional balance that we want. I do feel like this month is going to be a little bit more challenging for Virgos than I had hoped it would be. But you come out the other side much happier because you realize what your limitations are and that you need to assert boundaries and that your rest is important. This is a good month for you guys to catch up on sleep, to relax, to chill out, to kind of be a little bit more mellow and low-key. And again, I do think that that's going to extend into April, that sort of energy. But then coming into April, it's like once you've taken that time to sort of like clear things out and sit down and relax and reflect, you'll have a better understanding of what it is that you want to manifest in your life, and therefore you'll be very, very adept at manifesting the things that you do desire. So good. What kind of things are maybe working against your happiness that are outside of your control? And it's this energy of like being concerned that, you know, either you're lying to yourself or that other people are deceiving you, that they are not communicating effectively, or that they're lying. But, you know, ultimately, this isn't that big of a disappointment because you sort of expected it. The energy that's at play that's working outside of your control that could be sort of a detriment to your happiness this month is that energy of confusion. And, you know, it's not because you're just a confused person who doesn't organize their thoughts when you organize everything else. It's just astrology or something. They're saying this is an opportunity for you to really figure out what it is that you love and what's important to you. And when you make a list of your values, then you can kind of make a plan of attack for how you want to go through your life. You know, this is a good way to assess maybe what your life purpose is, or, you know, what it is you want to, if we have a limited amount of time every day, where do I want to spend most of my time? You know, so that sort of an energy here. What is going to bring you luck this month? And so your luckiest day this month, Virgo, is the 18th of March. And then your power color for the month is aqua. And I mean, nothing is coincidence, right? It says experience, peace, and calm. You see how this water is calm? And we had the Six of Swords energy with the, you know, moving on from tumultuous, you know, emotional circumstance to a place of peace and calm. And this is a divine number. It's 33. It's the number of the ascended masters. And so they're saying spirit is with you, but a 3 plus a 3 is a 6, even though we typically don't combine 11s and 33s. It still is applicable in this situation because it reinforces again the energy of balance and how important that is for you in the month of March. We had that imagery with the Temperance card. We had it with the Justice card. It's very, very important. And so this one is going to create serenity and tranquility in your mind, you know, that element of peace. It's going to soothe your nerves and your fears to give you that bravery to really embrace the Empress energy. And instead of just sitting there in a situation that sucks, do something to change it, okay? This is about advocating for yourself and advocating for others. And so this one dissolves your fears and increases your confidence. So if you have an aqua stone that you want to carry in your pocket, that would be great. If you wear this color or, you know, write with an aqua pen, you could find that this color is going to help you a tremendous amount. You know, using color energies, we kind of imagine that color going through our body and picking up anything toxic and kind of, you know, like either pushing it down into the earth or blowing it out, you know, breathing in this aqua color ray and then exhaling anything that needs to go from our body is a way to use that. Your affirmation with this one is, Divine Spirit, infuse me with aqua light, calm my nerves, and allow me to experience a sense of peace and tranquility. So that one correlates to your throat chakra. So if you want to imagine a light coming in here to heal it, that would be great. And then your crystal of the month is the lapis lazuli. Hey, surprise! When we talked about, you know, potentially people not communicating effectively and stuff with you, this one also correlates to the throat chakra. So this is a big important thing for you this month to work on. Now the lapis in tumbled form looks like this or like this. Can you see it? So you can get one from your local rock shop. If you purchase one from my website, it also comes with a video series on how to use crystals and, you know, exactly what it does, which angels are associated with it, how to care for it, blah, blah, blah. But I'll just tell you a little bit about what the lapis lazuli crystal does. This one is actually a very precious sort of stone because historically, this one goes back as like a spiritual tool to the Egyptian times. It's all about wisdom, kindness, love, harmony. It protects us against negative energies, and that's important once we kind of clear out our energy because we seem to be the one who is attacking ourselves with our negative energy this month. It gives you a lot of clarity, which is important when we have this element of like discernment and judgment and, you know, kind of clearing away confusion. It gives you clear thinking, self-awareness, helps you to create visions for the future, which, you know, we talked about is very important. Opens up your throat chakra, helps you to get rid of any repressed anger or fear. It expands all of your senses and kind of opens up the third eye. A lot of people say that this stone is not correlated to the throat, that it's correlated to the third eye. You can use it either way, you know, whatever you feel. You can use it both places. What else does it do? It creates a lot of balance in relationships. It connects the heart and the head, and that's kind of what is going to help you bring balance into your relationships, including your relationship with yourself. It helps us to look at our illusions and be really honest with ourselves, looking at our dark side and saying, hey, you know, why did I repress this thing here? Why am I stuffing this shit in my subconscious and not dealing with it? So then it helps us to be more concentrated and to be more mindful. It sometimes, you know, and so that you might want to be careful with this and use it for small amounts of periods of time. Like you don't want to like sleep with this under your pillow maybe this month, because in tandem with a Mercury retrograde, this has the capacity to bring up like repressed traumas and kind of help us to work through them and get past them, you know, because subconsciously they're affecting us in our day-to-day life. And it's awesome to heal from those things, but you know, meanwhile, in a Mercury retrograde type of energy, when we're already kind of dealing with that sort of energetic, you know, stuff coming up anyhow, it might be a really big emotional thing. So once you get through to the other side, you know, it's going to feel great. But in the thick of it, it might be a little bit challenging, but it does help you to express healthier emotions. And so Anyway, it does a lot of other things. You could look those up on my website if you would like to. And then we'll get back to what we're doing with our reading here. Now, what kind of energies do you need to bring into your life to help your happiness thrive? And they're saying, remembering that you're safe at all times. That at all times you have what you need and you're in the right place in the right time. Okay, that you are surrounded and protected by the spirit worlds, by your guardian angels and all of that. Like, you're not dead yet. So far, you have a 100% success rate of getting through shit that's tough, regardless of circumstance. Like, things might seem really dismal and dire for some of you and others of you not so much. But, you know, you'll get through this because you've gotten through everything else so far, you know? Okay, so how do you sustain your happiness once you get it? And they say, don't be so sensitive. Don't be over emotional. Understand that things can change for you in a very positive way overnight. And my right ear is ringing as I say that. So this is a very powerful truth. Today might be, you know, this circumstance or this energy, but tomorrow could be completely different. And I mean, you hear about these things all the time, you know, like overnight successes. Like, oh yeah, I was making $20 a week strumming my guitar on a street corner, somebody made a YouTube video, and now overnight that went viral, and I am a celebrity about to win a Grammy. You know, things happen. Miracles happen, and they happen overnight, but you have to believe that, and you have to remember that you are safe and secure at all times. So, March overall, in a nutshell for you, they say stop worrying, increase balance. And they're also saying, you know, it is a really good thing for you to be generous with your time, with your energy, with your love, but only if it's in a balanced way. And you don't want to, what is that phrase? You don't want to light yourself on fire to keep other people warm. They're saying this is why you don't always feel confident, because even if you're not setting an expectation for other people to behave a certain way, like, oh, I'm going to give you a ton of love. And don't worry, I don't expect anything in return. Subconsciously, you'd be like, why are they not thankful? Why is it when I need this friend that they are, you know, not there for me and I'm always there for them, or whatever the case may be? Then this depletes your self-esteem and you're taking it super personal, when really what you need to do is you say, oh, you know what? Maybe I shouldn't give so much of my energy to this person. Maybe this is a toxic situation I need to step away from. They're saying this is how you do self-care. And self-care is very important for you this month. You need to focus on putting yourself first before others. And I know that you're a very loving person, and this is why, you know, you sort of do these things. And, you know, why you give your criticisms to others, because you want everyone to be the best version of themselves. But the thing is, like, unless you're talking about your children, it's not your job to correct or fix people, except for you. You know, we are supposed to teach our children how to grow and, you know, how to be the best version of themselves. But it is not our responsibility to do that for our spouse, for our siblings, for our best friends. We can be there for them. We can give our guidance when they ask us. But, you know, we do not need to be responsible for that. If they are adult people, they are responsible for their own well-being, and therefore you are also responsible for your own well-being, which sometimes means creating boundaries. So I wanted to tell you, like, a lot more joyful stuff. I think this is a really, it's like a working month, you know, where sometimes we might watch a TV show and we're like, oh my gosh, I usually really love the show and this new season is so boring. And you're like, why is this so boring? Well, it's because they're setting the stage. They're, you know, kind of laying the foundation or the groundwork in the first three boring ass episodes for this amazing, like, mind-blowing episode 4 and 5, where you're like, oh my God, this is why I love the show and why I'm so addicted, you know? So that's kind of what's going on with you. So it's nothing bad, but a lot of you are maybe inclined to sort of ignore the work you're supposed to be doing this month. And they're saying here, look, things can change for you overnight, but did you do the work to prepare for that? You know, if you didn't go and strum your guitar on the street corner, like, nothing's going to happen for you. And so do the work, okay? I love you so much. And getting all the way to the end of it. I really appreciate your support. If you are interested in other videos, click here. If you are interested in subscribing, go ahead and click here. Hit that notification bell so that you get alerted to when new videos come out and also when I do surprise live streams. And then if you're interested in winning a free 20-minute video reading personally every month, go ahead and click right here. Mwah!